Haynes is back with week two picks. Now, I haven't made a video in 5 days. I'm sorry, guys. I've been very, very busy. I had to do a lot of work and stuff. A lot of stuff I had to deal with a lot of people and whatnot. I just had to get through that. And I'm going to be start making my week two picks right now. Now, we're going to have the Houston versus Cincinnati game in about T-minus 40-ish minutes, and I'm going to start with that one. This one I got Houston. Houston historically does well against Cincinnati, or at least in recent memory, and also Cincinnati is playing in prime time. Yes, sirree, yes, and they are not very good in prime time. Sorry for that, Bengals fans, but they tend to struggle right there. And Houston, you're going to have Deshaun Watson, who I'm going to be calling as a nickname DW. I think that would be pretty funny. I think that he's going to be pretty good tonight. I think he'd be okay. Definitely got his first touchdown pass last week. I know it's against the Jacksonville Jaguars, but I think he will get his first victory. Now, next one is I got Miami versus the LA Chargers. I got the Chargers as the one. The Chargers definitely do have a talented offense. They just need to play more consistently. I think when I look at Phillip Rivers is one of the more accurate quarterbacks in the NFL, and I definitely think that if maybe the Chargers were a little bit better, like this guy's probably good enough to win a Super Bowl and whatnot. He hasn't been in the playoffs in a little while. However, it is against Miami. They are facing Jay Cutler, and the Chargers don't have a terrible defense. A lot of people don't really think of their defense too much, but Casey Hayward's a quality player. Joey Bosa is a quality player. I think it would be close, but I'm picking the Chargers at this one, and it will be in LA, so I'm picking the home team right here. Now, Tennessee versus Jacksonville. Now, some people are thinking that Jacksonville will start off the season 2-0, which is like the first time in like their history, probably. But when you look at Tennessee, Tennessee actually has a good offensive line, unlike Houston. Houston has a terrible offensive line. Yes, I know Jacksonville racked up 10 sacks, 4 by Calais Campbell, an impressive feat for the Jaguars. However, they're facing a much better offensive line, and they're also facing a quarterback with actual mobility to them. Yes, they did face Deshaun Watson last week. However, they faced Tom Savage in the beginning, who is not known for being a mobile quarterback, but you got the Titans right there. And also, when you look at that, the Titans definitely might not have a great defense. However, they held Oakland to 26 points, which is okay, I guess. I expected maybe Oakland to score maybe 30. However, they didn't do that bad of a job, and I think they should do pretty well against the Jaguars because Blake Bortles isn't that good. He didn't show anything last week, and they just lost Allen Robinson, I want to say, for the season. And to top it off, the Tennessee Titans have a very good goal line deep offense, and I feel like the Jaguars, their only touchdown they gave up last week was on the goal line to a rookie quarterback that a lot of people thought maybe wasn't even ready for the pros. I definitely didn't think he's ready for the pros, even though I think he's going to be the most successful quarterback out of the 2017 draft. I don't think he's exactly ready yet, but I definitely see something right there with Tennessee, and I think Tennessee is going to win this game pretty easily, and then people are going to jump off the Jaguars bandwagon right there. Their first ever bandwagon, probably. Now, the next one is Cleveland versus Baltimore. I got Baltimore in this one. First things first, Baltimore is playing at home, and not only that, the Baltimore defense definitely played pretty solid on Sunday. Actually, they played fantastic on Sunday, but obviously Andy Dalton freaking sucked. Now they're going to be facing Deshaun Kizer, who looks okay. He definitely does look okay. I think the Browns probably found the greatest quarterback ever in their history since like the merger and whatnot. And I think when I look at Baltimore, their defense is definitely going to eat them up. Now they have a cornerback in Brandon Carr. I think that plays a huge role right there. And I definitely think that's definitely going to play a big role right there because the Steelers don't really have a corner they're going to be playing. The only issue is the Ravens don't really have the offensive firepower. It's my one concern. I think it might be a very low-scoring game. It might be a 14-10 game, but I still got Baltimore in this one. Now you got Dallas versus Denver. Now, Dallas wasn't a team I was very big on the beginning of the season because, well, before the season because of Ezekiel Elliott's injury. However, Ezekiel Elliott's back, and I think that Denver did not build their team to be a run-stuffing team, and Ezekiel Elliott, I think, could have a really easy day against them. Well, not a really easy day, but I could see a 100-yard rushing game. I don't expect much from Dak Prescott, and when I look at Simeon could make a couple plays here and there. It might be a close game, and to be honest, I might want to say Denver in this one, but I feel like I have to go with Dallas because you got the great old line in Dallas and that running game. I think that's going to take them away versus the Denver Broncos offensive firepower. isn't exactly there. They didn't play bad against the Chargers. They didn't. I just feel as if that the Dallas, I think they'll win this one. I think they're going to score more points than what the Chargers did. Obviously, Denver has a great defense. It's still not something. I'm not 100% confident can Dallas can win this one, but I'm pulling for them in this game. Now, next one is Philadelphia versus Kansas City. Now, I got the Chiefs in this one. I think the Chiefs' defense, even though they lost Eric Berry, I think they're going to play very well. And I think that defense will do a good job against Carson Wentz. There's still some big errors that Wentz made here and there in that game, but he made some spectacular plays here and there. But it's going to be hard to make plays against Kansas City. And I think their cornerbacks for the Eagles are usually atrocious. So I expect the game to be close, but I got the Chiefs in this one. It's also an Arrowhead, so please, it's going to be hard to beat the Chiefs there. Now, you got Arizona versus the Indianapolis Colts. Now, you're going to have Jacoby Brissett playing. I do not think Jacoby Brissett is ready to play in the NFL. And also, one thing for sure about Arizona, Arizona's talented. I know Patrick Peterson had didn't play as well as everyone thought he did. However, it was against Kenny Golladay, whatever this guy's name is. However, he looked pretty good out there. I just think that there's a difference between facing Matt Stafford and Jacoby Brissett. Matt Stafford, NFL veteran. He's also around 30 years old. Yikes, I know. Time flies. And then you got Jacoby Brissett. Quarterback, you kind of have to treat him like a rookie quarterback just because how he's going to play. And I think Arizona's just going to win this one. I just got Arizona, even though it's on the road. Now, next one, you got Buffalo versus Carolina. Now, this one's going to be a close one. However, I'm going to pick Carolina at home simply because Carolina is... There are a team that I think they'll do well against Buffalo. It's going to be a close one, though. I just think that the offensive firepower of the Buffalo Bills will not be there. Obviously, don't have much offensive firepower. I just think that if you have Luke Kuechly and Thomas Davis and Quan Short, that I don't think LeSean McCoy is going to have a field day on them. I just simply just don't. It's possible that they can't. And also, I look at the Buffalo Bills defense. It's talented. I'll give them that. It's a talented defense, but it's a defense that hasn't really lived up to its full potential. I think Cam Newton will have a pretty good day. Obviously, he didn't have a great day against San Francisco. Obviously, Newton still has his struggles, but I got Carolina in this one. Next one, we got Minnesota versus Pittsburgh. Now, I got Minnesota in this one. I know it's going to be on the road at Pittsburgh. However, I think that the Vikings have a real good defense right there. And also, I think Sam Bradford, I really, really liked what I saw. I think Sam Bradford's better than Alex Smith, just to tell you. And that's the reason why I think Sam Bradford won Offensive Player of the Week right there. I think he's a good player. Dalvin Cook, they have a running game. It looks like their offense is actually playing pretty well. And that Steelers defense isn't exactly stellar. It's not what it used to be. And Pittsburgh played too close of a game to Cleveland. And I just feel I'm just going to pick Minnesota in this one. I think even though it's on the road, I just think that it's a running team. And I think they should really not have any problem playing on grass right there. Now, the next one is Chicago versus Tampa Bay. It's going to be in Tampa. I got Tampa in this one. Chicago still struggles on defense. I know the Atlanta Falcons weren't amazing on Sunday offensively against the Bears. However, I'm not a big Mike Glennon guy. I'm just not. They know who Mike Glennon is. Obviously, Mike Glennon might know what Tampa is. However, I think Tampa will do a better job holding them and whatnot. Now, the next one is I got Washington versus LA. I got the LA Rams in this one. Now, I don't think the Rams are going to make the playoffs. However, I think that front seven is going to eat up the Washington Redskins offensive line. I think Taron Williams, I'm blanking on his name, but Williams, one of their big left tackles, who's a quality player. He's been in the NFL for a while now. He got kind of banged up last week. And also, I think that if you got that Rams D-line, is going to do a good job. And I think Jared Goff is on Carson Wentz's level, I would say. So I got the Rams in this one. It's going to be a close one, Redskins, but the Rams are going to make you look like the potato skins. Now, next one is San Francisco versus Seattle. Seattle's definitely struggling offensively. The run game's not there. The offensive line game's not there. The passing game's not there. They just didn't play a very good game last Sunday. However, I got Seattle to win this one. It's against San Francisco. Even though I'm a big Kyle Shanahan guy, I think Kyle Shanahan It will take them into the right direction. I think he's their messiah, you could so say. It might be a little bit strong, but I think Kyle Shanahan will bring in a good culture. I think John Lynch knows what he's doing. I just think Seattle will win this one. It's just easy. I think Seattle might win this game 17-3. I think the offense will still struggle. However, Seattle, there's something that the difference between San Francisco and Seattle is quite different. Seattle has talent. San Francisco does not. That's simple. And I feel like San Francisco won't be as terrible as what everyone thinks it is, but I got Seattle in this one. I don't really see them pulling out a win right here, especially in Seattle. So it's going to be right here. Next one you got is Green Bay versus Atlanta. Now, I definitely think Atlanta's going to win this one because, what number one, it's a home game for Atlanta. And number two, I think the defense of the Atlanta Falcons has improved significantly. I made a video about that. Click on the link in the description if you're interested about how they'll do. And I definitely think that the Green Bay Packers cornerbacks are still not that very great. They're not very great, and they're going to be playing a dome, so it's going to be at a disadvantage. They're not playing, and Green Bay is a far better home team than they are an away team. Obviously, Green Bay can still actually – they're not like the Saints, who I'm going to get to a little bit later. Not like the Saints. I know they've changed over the years. They've become a better road team as gone on. I mean, what they do in the playoffs, obviously, they've been playing on the road, usually for the most part. And I just think that Atlanta will just win this game. I think they just match up very well. And Green Bay doesn't really adjust. And I feel like I just like what Atlanta has on their roster versus what Green Bay has on their roster. Now, next one is Detroit versus the New York Giants. Now, obviously, the New York Giants are my Super Bowl pick. But however, last Sunday, they looked atrocious. And I think partially blame is Eli Manning. Now, Eli Manning, I got faith for that guy to at least pull something that he can at least return to maybe his 2011 form. However, without Odell Beckham Jr., they just need that speed receiver out there who they can just throw to so they can defeat that zone coverage that Eli, for some reason, just can't pass through. And then you've got Brandon Marshall against Mann. Because Marshall, they have Brandon Marshall. I think he can still play. But Eli has to throw the damn ball. And I think Eli, his footwork looks terrible out there. He looks like a rookie quarterback at times because he's just so freaking inaccurate. And this is what I bring up. I feel like Eli Manning thrives a lot better when he has protection. And that might sound a little bit obvious. However, I feel like there's some quarterbacks that absolutely need protection and quarterbacks that don't necessarily need protection. Eli Manning is that quarterback I think needs it. He just... because whenever he like rolls out or he tries to do something on the road or he tries to do when he feels rushed, he's just throwing out all over the place. I mean, Brandon Marshall's 6'5", somewhere around there, and when you got Eli Manning, how can you miss a target like that? But I'm still picking the Giants to adjust, go to the Super Bowl for the NFC. But I got Detroit in this one. I really like Matt Stafford. Matt Stafford has great character. I absolutely love his character. Yes, he threw a pick six to open up the game last week, but he rebounded great. That's what I love about Stafford. Stafford has character. I think he really does that. He's also a gifted quarterback. Some people were pulling him for MVP. Not necessarily me, but there were some people pulling him for MVP. I think he's easily a top 10 quarterback in this league right now. He's changed a lot. What I saw of him in 2016 was very impressive. And Detroit... personnel-wise, they're the less talented team, but they lost to Arizona, which was a far more talented team. And I think I just got Detroit in this one. They played a close game last year. Now they have Darius Slay. I believe he's going to be healthy. Now you have this Ken Golladay. I'm blanking on his name, but a wide receiver that did really well against Patrick Peterson. He was a G out there. His last name starts with a G. So, hey, I got Detroit in this one. And Detroit played a close game one with them last year. So I think Detroit's going to pull up the win right here on the road. Now, the fan pick, guys. New England versus New Orleans. Now, you got New England. Obviously, you had all those Saints about the undefeated season. Ain't wrong. Not undefeated. They start off the season 0-1. However, New England, they might just win the Super Bowl this year if they can, obviously. So, you got them against New Orleans, which is a very good road team. That's the fan pick right there. I'm allowing it up to you guys to decide right there. All right, guys, sorry for not making a video up there recently. If you want to do the same website that I've been using, it was shout out to a subscriber right here, Sean D Obviously, he gave me the link for this. Link's in the description if you're interested. I'll see you guys next time. Peace.